Joining me now from our Washington bureau to discuss the situation in Iran is Karim Sadjadpour. He's with the Carnegie Endowment for International Peace. Let me first ask you a question about today's proceedings. How significant are they in the grand scheme of things?
Well, Don, Mahmoud Ahmadinejad, I would argue, is the most divisive figure in the 30-year history of the Islamic Republic. Some have often called him a skilled politician. I would say he's an incredibly unskilled politician in the sense that he gratuitously alienates not only reformists and moderates, but also his fellow hardliners. And I think the tumult which we've seen in the last 6 weeks in Iran has been truly unprecedented, and it's not over yet. I think that there's still an incredible sense of outrage and injustice at a popular level, and incredible rifts at the levels of the political elite, which are not going to be reconciled anytime soon.
So I was going to ask you, will securing Ahmadinejad as the president once again make it actually any easier or actually harder for the government to try and calm everything down?
Well, I don't see it making it any easier because people are not going to stop their agitation simply because Ahmadinejad has been officially inaugurated by Ayatollah Khamenei. I think people look back at the June 12th elections and say they were illegitimate, and he's an illegitimate president. And what's transpired over the last 6 weeks, Don, is very important because whereas before the election this was a referendum on Ahmadinejad's presidency, I think post-election it's really become a referendum on how Iran is governed. It's a referendum on the Islamic Republic itself. And I think people, after 30 years of tremendous repression, are feeling that, you know, they want a new Iran which joins the international community, and they want to see their country emerge from the self-inflicted isolation.
If there is one, if there's going to be one, what will be the tipping point then?
It's a very good point, Don. I would argue that we've seen, as I said, tremendous rifts at the levels of the political elite. What's going to be key is the rifts at the levels of the security elite, namely among military entities like the Revolutionary Guards. Behind the scenes, we know that these groups are not monolithic. There's tremendous diversity. But so far, at the senior command level, they've shown a unity of purpose. When and if we start seeing rifts among those levels, it could be fatal for President Ahmadinejad and Ayatollah Khamenei.
All right. Karim Sadjadpour, thanks very much for your analysis on the show today. Thank you.
Thank you.